Today on Better Book Clubs, Maggie O'Farrell's stunning novel, Hamnet. This is probably the best novel I've read this year. I want to talk a little bit, not so much about what the book is about, but about why it works. The book has gotten a lot of attention, but what I was really kind of fascinated by as I finished it and felt so satisfied by it was why. I kind of avoided reading this book when it first came out because it's subtitled A Novel of the Plague. I really just wasn't in the mood to read it in the middle of a pandemic. But eventually I came around and I thought, okay, I'm gonna take it on. I knew that it was gonna be a difficult subject, not only because of the plague, but also because it's about the death of Shakespeare's son, Hamnet. And anytime you're reading about the death of a child, you know that it's going to be heavy reading. So I went into it knowing that it was probably beautifully written, that a lot of people had liked it, but I wasn't sure that I was going to like it. So I was really pleasantly surprised and then completely engrossed. I really just couldn't put it down. And yet I wasn't sure why I couldn't put it down, because it's a difficult subject matter and it's not exactly a page turner in terms of plot. We know all kinds of things going into it. First of all, it's going to be about the plague. We know the child is going to die. We know it's Shakespeare's child. There's just really not a whole lot of surprise involved there. So how is Maggie O'Farrell going to draw me through this whole book and keep me going and keep me interested? The fact that she did was kind of a puzzle at the end that I had to go back and think about. So what I actually want to share with you today is several reasons why I think this book works. But first, I'll give you just the tiniest bit of information about it if you're not familiar with it. The book runs from the period of 1580, when Shakespeare is just a young Latin tutor, to the year 1609, when his play Hamlet was first produced. It's a fairly broad time period. It's not just about the plague. The other thing is that, according to the author's note, you know, Maggie O'Farrell does what a lot of writers of historical fiction do, and she talks about the changes that she made and the ways in which she was filling in some gaps in the historical record. Nobody really knows what Shakespeare's son Hamnet died of. And she says, his burial is listed, but not the cause of his death. The Black Death, or pestilence, as it would have been known in the late 16th century, is not mentioned once by Shakespeare in any of his plays or poetry. I have always wondered about this absence and its possible significance. This novel is the result of my idle speculation. So it's kind of interesting to know what spurred O'Farrell to write the novel in the first place. So, my guiding question for this video, what makes such a dark novel with so little plot so compelling? Well, the first thing is something that I talk about all the time in my videos, and that's just that it's gorgeous writing. And I'll just share one brief passage with you. And then if you're interested in learning more about what I mean when I talk about gorgeous writing, I have a whole video on that, and you can take a look at that and learn a little bit more. For now, let me just read you a couple of paragraphs from page 16, so very early in the novel. And this is a little passage about Shakespeare's wife, Agnes, the mother of Hamnet. But this is before she and Shakespeare have gotten together. Agnes is circling the skeps, listening for whatever the bees are telling her. She is eyeing the swarm in the orchard, a blackish stain spread throughout the branches that vibrates and quivers with outrage. Something has upset them. The weather, a change in temperature, or has someone disturbed the hive? One of the children, some escaped sheep, her stepmother? She slides her hand up and under into the skep, past its lip through the remaining coating of bees. She is cool in a shift under the dark river-colored shade of the trees, her thick braid of hair pinned to the top of her head, hidden under a white coif. No beekeeper veil covers her face. She never wears one. If you came close enough, you would see that her lips are moving, murmuring small sounds and clicks to the insects that circle her head, a light on her sleeve, blunder into her face. So this is the first and most obvious thing that really makes Hamnet readable. It's just beautifully written. The second thing is something that you can also kind of start to hear in that passage, which is the world building that Maggie O'Farrell does. So even though she doesn't have a whole lot of historical information about Shakespeare and his family, his wife and his children, she builds the entire world of Stratford-upon-Avon so that you feel that you're there. You feel that you're there in that time and place. There are tons of details about everyday life, about sensory details, about things that also make this a place that even though you're reading a dark and sad story, it's a place that you want to stay. The third thing that makes it a really compelling read is, of course, Shakespeare himself. But the interesting thing is that he's barely present in this novel. So he's there, he's a character, and we know it's him, but for a lot of the novel, he's away in London or wherever else he is doing his theatrical thing, and his wife is left to raise their children and to deal with all of the difficulties that come along with that, including, most importantly, the loss of their son. And so while Shakespeare makes appearances, the novel isn't really about him in a way that makes it more compelling because he's a little bit of a mysterious, shadowy figure around the edges of the novel. So connected with that is another thing that I think made the novel keep moving forward for me, and that was the question of when is Hamlet gonna show up? You can see that the child's name is Hamnet with an N, and the play we all know is Hamlet with an L. Somewhere, something I read said that those two names were somewhat interchangeable. O'Farrell doesn't really attempt to explain why the name gets changed, but certainly you understand throughout the novel that somehow this child is going to inspire that play. And I think that question of why, like how is that going to happen and how is that going to play out, is the unstated but driving question of the novel. At least it was for me. If that's the question that is kind of driving you through the novel, even sort of in the back of your mind, the ending of the novel is very satisfying. I want to add that you don't need to be familiar with Hamlet really at all in order to appreciate or understand this novel and in order to appreciate or understand the ending of this novel. So O'Farrell really sticks the ending, and I think that's one thing that we absolutely have to have if we're going to walk away from a novel loving it. I think there's one more element that makes this novel a novel that it's hard to put down, and that's the character of Agnes. O'Farrell says she didn't have very much to work with in the historical record, so she's created a really compelling, kind of wild, interesting, complex woman in the role of Shakespeare's wife, the mother of Hamnet. If we weren't so interested in her, it would also be hard to be interested in the story, but she's just such a compelling, interesting character that you want to follow her through and see how is she going to respond to what's happening and how is she going to cope with it and what's going to happen to her. I'm not going to tell you anything more about Hamnet because I want you to read it for yourself and see what you think. I'd be especially interested to hear what you think if you have other ideas about what makes this a really great novel. I always like to kind of pull up the hood and tinker around in the engine to figure out what makes a piece of writing work. Also, it kind of goes without saying, Hamnet is a great choice for your book club, and I hope you'll take it on together. If you like what you see here, please subscribe, and I'll be back soon with another episode of Better Book Clubs.